So in today's video, I want to talk a little bit about my digital bullet journal. And I know that many of you are already rolling your eyes thinking, oh, digital, ugh, I need pen and paper to think. Then trust me, I was the same, I always thought the same, but nowadays that I really embrace the digital version of my bullet journal, I would not want to go back. So in today's video, I'm going to talk about the 5 mindset shifts that enabled me to really switch to digital, and also I'm going to show you a little bit how I do it. I am bullet journaling since about 10 years, and back then my life was quite chaotic and quite a mess. I just got into my first full-time job after I did my bachelor's degree. I started at a startup, which was quite hectic. Plus, at the same time, I thought it's a good idea to do my master's degree. So my life was really, I thought I cannot do it all. And then one day I saw the video of writer Carol, where he explained the bullet journal method. And honestly, I was immediately hooked, and I realized that just with a piece of paper and a black pen, I can really get my life back on track. And since then, in the last 10 years, my bullet journal really helped me achieve many milestones in my life. I obviously got my master's degree. At some point, I decided to leave my job and start my own business. I got married. I decided to give up my apartment, sold all my things, and became location independent. So as you can imagine, my life really went through many changes in the last 10 years. And even though I'm very minimalist with my bullet journal, I always fell behind with trying to migrate all my tasks or setting up the weekly pages just because I was so busy. And I will never forget that historic day a few years ago where I spilled a big bowl of creamy tomato soup right over my bullet journal and all my tasks and everything was gone. And that was the day I decided to go digital, and I planned to do it on my computer. I set up a very fancy Notion dashboard and everything. And as you can guess, very soon I was back on paper again, and I really thought that I really need pen and paper, digital just. But as it turns out, I was wrong about that. And in the last few years, technology really changed a lot, and it really enables me now to use a digital bullet journal. And I'm very happy to say that now, after 10 years, I finally found planner peace. So my first mindset shift was that I just want to write by hand. It turns out what I was missing was really not pen and paper, it was just being able to write by hand. And for that, nowadays, I don't necessarily need a notebook anymore. My favorite iPad for bullet journaling is the iPad mini and the pencil, because it basically has the size of a normal notebook. Then I have a magnetic case for my iPad with a flap here that always secures the pencil to the side. I also use paper like screen protectors, even though they wear out every 2 or 3 months, so I need to exchange them a lot, but they just make writing on the iPad feel a lot better. And I use the app Goodnotes, but any other note-taking app that supports the Apple Pencil will work. And just in case you're wondering, I'm still on Goodnotes 5. They did not excite me enough to upgrade to Goodnotes 6 yet. So with the help of the iPad and the pencil, I was able to basically merge digital and analog into a system that works for me. And to make it very dramatic, that's kind of how I rose like the phoenix from the ashes and left the limitations of my paper notebook behind me. So I just use an empty GoodNotes document, and the only setting that I basically changed is that I can scroll my pages because I find it faster to flip through my notebook. And I really fell in love with the flexibility of digital. Because when I need it, I can move things around, I can delete and rewrite things I messed up, I can copy and paste things to other places. And just these few functions already make the weekly review and my task migrating so much faster. I also enjoy that I can create my own templates and just copy and paste and reuse them if I need them. I love it that I have no more space limitations, because if I run out of space, I just add another page. And even though I'm not into stickers or anything, I also enjoy that I can add images and photos to my digital bullet journal. For example, when I was planning our route for our trip to Brazil, I copied the map into it and tried to figure out the stops on the way. Or I also have a collections where I add the covers of the books I read this year. And if I put any notes for those books into my long-term storage in my second brain, then I can just link it, and with a tap of the cover, it immediately takes me to Craft, where I can see my notes. I also have a separate notebook in Goodnotes that I share with my husband. So there we meal plan together or we write to-do lists that both of us have to do, and it automatically syncs with his Goodnotes and vice versa. And another thing I really, really enjoy is the search function, because I dread in the old days when I knew I wrote something down in one of my notebooks from last year that I had to go and manually search through the whole thing. Nowadays, I just use the search and immediately find what I'm looking for in seconds. And I also really enjoy all the other advantages, like using split screen with other apps or being able to scan stuff into my bullet journal. So I'm sorry, pen and paper, you just can't live up to that. Mindset shift number two is that digital is more minimalist. So even as the minimalist planner that I was, I accumulated a huge stack of notebooks and lots of pens during the last 10 years. But now that I gave up my apartment and gave away all my things and I live out of a 30-liter backpack, I'm really obsessed with keeping things as minimal as possible. And since I have my iPad mini with me anyways all the time, because I also use it for reading and things, I don't need any additional gear to get my bullet journal done. So mindset shift number three, not everything is useful in the long run. When I gave my apartment a few years ago, I also had to get rid of all my old bullet journals, but I wanted to keep the information that was important to me. So I really spent days looking through all my old notebooks, trying to see what's still useful and scan it. And I got really, really annoyed because there was just so much useless stuff in these bullet journals that I don't need anymore. For example, do I really need to know 6 years later that I had to go buy milk? So nowadays I'm really restrictive what goes into my bullet journal, because for me, I realized there are two types of notes and it really depends on their usefulness over time. There are things that I want to keep forever, that I really refer back to at a regular basis, and there are things that are more short term. One thing that I did was that I separated all those things into separate notebooks. So one of my notebooks contains my collections. They are kind of my long-term collections that I need over longer periods of time. And I really enjoy it that they're always there organized in a separate notebook and I don't have to manually transfer them from notebook to notebook when I migrate my books. Then I also have another notebook for my monthly planning. I have a notebook for my project plans. And another notebook that I have is called Today, where I basically write my rapid logs for every day, where I do my brain dumps, all those things. And at the end of the day, when I'm done with it, I probably merge the information I need on a longer period into my collections, but all those things in there, they can just go. So they really had their purpose for the day, and once they're no longer useful, I don't have a problem letting them go. And this mindset shift was a very important one for me because I realized at the end of the day, it does not matter where I have my to-do list, as long as I have one for the day. Nowadays, I'm just very flexible and whatever works for me for the day, I just write it there. Sometimes I write my daily to-do list on my iPad. Sometimes I just write it on a scrap of paper if I know I'm not at home. Or I put it on my task manager so I can see it on my Apple Watch during the day. I'm really flexible now and it doesn't matter anymore because I know this information serves me for the day and then it can go. Mindset shift number four. The bullet journal is more than a notebook. And since I started to be so flexible with my short-term things, I really realized that the bullet journal is much more than a notebook. One of the reasons why the bullet journal works is because it really gives you a dedicated place to put your tasks and your notes. But it does not really matter if you really put the thing into a notebook, as long as you have a clearly defined spot for it to go. And nowadays, my bullet journal is a wild mix, but I can trust it 100% and I feel that I'm more organized than ever. So let me just give you a quick overview of how my bullet journal is organized nowadays. As I mentioned, all my collections are in Goodnotes, but I'm really restrictive about what stays in there. If something is done, but I still want to keep the information, for example, I migrate it into Craft, which I use basically as my second brain. And I know if I ever need to refer back to it, it's there, but it does not clutter up my bullet journal anymore. For the index, I just use the Goodnotes bookmark function. It makes it very easy to find my things in the notebook, and it doesn't matter anymore if I add pages in between. I honestly no longer have a future log. All the things that are events are now in my Google Calendar, which makes much more sense for me because I also have to share it with other people. And all those tasks that I don't need anymore, I store in Things 3. So I kind of use Things 3 as my someday maybe list. And it also reminds me of all those adulting tasks, like, I don't know, change the toothbrush every 3 months. Another thing that I really enjoy about this digital solution is when I do a brain dump in Goodnotes, I can just convert the whole thing into text and copy it over to Things 3 and just have it organized there. And I also use Things 3 as kind of an inbox for the tasks when I'm out and about, because it's not always easy to really have a bullet journal with you. And I can already kind of hear you thinking, Maggie, that's more than one place where you keep your things. And yes, that's true. But for me, it's already second nature. And I know that every day I have to check my calendar. I check my Today notebook where I have the rapid logs and the open tasks. And I also check my Things 3 for tasks that newly popped up and are due today or soon. And out of those three, I basically create one to-do list for the day, wherever it is. And mindset shift number 5, accessibility. And one thing that I was missing for a long time in Goodnotes was the ability that I have with a paper notebook, for example, that immediately I can open it to any page I want. And it's super fast. But I was able to replicate the same thing on my iPad at some point when I found this floating dot that I can move anywhere on the screen. And when I tap on it once, it opens all my Goodnotes notebooks. And when I tap on it twice, it opens a split screen with Things 3 on one side and my calendar on the other side. And thanks to that dot, it doesn't matter anymore what I'm doing on my iPad or which program I'm in. As soon as I tap the dot, I'm in my bullet journal and ready to go. Another benefit of my digital bullet journal is that I can access it from anywhere. So I can open it on my iPad mini, on my larger iPad, on my phone. And another thing that I really, really love, especially after that soup incident, is that Goodnotes automatically creates 2 backups for me. So it backs up the Goodnotes file that I always have, the original file, but it also always puts a PDF of my bullet journal into my Google Drive. So even if I would lose everything, as long as I find a computer somewhere with access to the internet, I can access my drive, I could access my bullet journal and find all the information again. And even though Goodnotes does not have that feature, some other note-taking apps allow you to protect your notebooks with a password. So if that would be important to you, you can just secure your notes and no one will see them. So these are basically the changes I made to my bullet journal over the years. Because one thing is for sure, my life and your life will change a lot, and it's very nice that there are systems out there that just adapt. And if you remember one thing from this video, I hope it's this, that it's all about you. Keep it flexible, try things, just stick to the system behind it and really give it a try. Because what works for me must not necessarily work for you. And it's only up to you to figure out what really works for you. So if you want to improve your Goodnotes skills, watch this video that I did a while ago about my favorite hacks that are also useful for my bullet journal. And Ryder, if you ever watch this, thank you so much for creating this system. You made the life of this girl here a lot better. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!